What's up, guys, and welcome back to Winfrey Fitness. All right, there's Caitlin acting silly. All right, guys, we about to go ahead and get in this back workout, but today we got a special guest, definitely for you ladies out there, you know what I'm saying, that's trying to get right and get tight. But I'm gonna stop talking because you guys already know enough about me. I'm gonna go ahead and turn over the camera to our special guest. So without further ado, hey!
Hi, girls! I'm Laura. I am actually a sponsored athlete at Fit Like Flint, which is a fitness brand that's dedicated to helping women become the healthier, best selves possible. So I am here today to talk a little about everyone's favorite topic, the ladies, that's the pull-ups. This is something that I get a lot of questions about. Like, girls are all the time asking me, how do you do one when you can't do any? Alright, so to start, we're going to talk a little bit about this handy tool right here.
Zoom in on this.
You got it?
Yep.
Okay, so these are pull-up bands. So you can get them in different levels of resistance. This one, I'm not totally sure, but I think it might be like 40 pounds worth. These are like going to be your best friend while you're trying to get into doing your very first pull-up. Demonstrate how to use them, but why they're so important. I don't know if you've ever tried using like the assisted pull-up machine, but it's basically providing assistance from pushing from below.
Right,
and
right.
It's kind of an unnatural movement, so it kind of works against you. Whereas these help put you in that natural state, that natural position when you're doing your pull-ups. All right, so first things first, we'll show you how to attach them. It's
yep.
Super bright in here, I'm like blinded in. But here we go. First things first, you're just going to take it and you're going to loop it over top of the main support beam. And just slide it through just like that. Voila.
If you didn't get that, rewind the video and just go right back and watch it, guys.
2 steps.
Yeah.
Right. I'm gonna go ahead and show them this down here. We set this up, guys. Listen, I had to set, I'm 5'8", and like I said, for you short people out there like us, you're definitely gonna wanna set up a chair, something, you know, cause you'll see. I'll do it for you guys.
You're 5'2", 5'3"? I am 5'2". Yeah, I like
Nation. Hey, how tall are you, baby?
Yeah, 5'2" Nation. But that's a whole other thing. Okay. So the other thing is, make sure if you're new to pull-ups that your hands aren't too far apart. This is going to be so much harder than having them closer together.
Exactly.
Okay, so if you're new, just getting started, keep them as close as possible. Okay, so next thing, put your feet together. Again, neck back, engage the legs.
Oops.
Let's go, girl. Come on.
What brand is that?
Reebok, I'm telling you.
Isn't that crazy?
They're like way stepping it up, guys. See, short girl problems and all that.
Bunches up at the bottom.
Hey, I'm about to give me some. What you got on, baby? What's them?
Pump chasers. well.
Look, let me see the logo. Let me see the logo. Woo! Yeah. Let me zoom in. Hold on. Let me focus. All right, now we back. All right, baby. Get it. Two. Keep going. Three. Keep the head up. Four. One more.
She got it.
Nice.
Your leg will fly up if you don't keep control of it. Yeah, be careful.
All right, man, let me get in on this. Let me get in.
I think you need more assistance. Let's just take a moment.
Oh my.
Alright, that's one leg. If I fall, we're gonna keep this on. I'm gonna do one leg, y'all.
Keep rolling.
And he's wider. Look how.
Such a manly man.
You can do this too. Like she said, it puts you in a better position than being in that, you know, being on the assistance. I've done the assistance before. I couldn't do this myself. I wish I kind of had something like this, but this is a great tool. Don't be ashamed if you're a guy. Get up on this, get your pull-ups. I love pull-ups. I feel like that's like, you can't cheat that workout.
No,
you can't fake doing a pull-up. You know, I love it, but
I guess my brain. One of the things that I started doing when I was getting really serious about wanting to be able to do just one unassisted pull-up is I bought one of those cheap over-the-door pull-up bars, and I stuck it like
yes.
When I was going to the bathroom. So I was like, all right, every trip I got to do one. All right, so and you can get this off of Amazon. I don't think it's more than maybe $25.
Nice. It's a good investment.
Oh, yeah. I was just about to use that. I was about to say a lot.
$25 for a bigger bag.
$25, and it's like investments. Whether it's like a weight belt, some wrist wraps, something like that. You know, making the investments is very important. But, so that's what we have for you guys today. Do you have anything else to say about this? Okay. That's what we have for you guys today. Definitely wanted to bring Laura onto the channel to kind of really relate to you females out there. I know you guys are really scared, or a lot of you make comments and say, well, I don't want to get real bulky. And yeah, that's not the case. If you guys want to see Laura again on the channel, go ahead and comment below and just ask for her to come back. You know, you ask for her.
Please come back, Laura. Sad emoji.
But no, guys, she's awesome. She knows a lot about nutrition as well. You guys always see me talk about how many donuts and things like that I eat, and I preach if it fits your macros. I got that from her. So I will put her Instagram in the description box and also her Facebook. And then she talked about the Fit Life Flint. For you females out there, that is an awesome, awesome group. So I think that's it, guys. We're going to go ahead and knock out some back and let you guys enjoy the rest of the video. You know, we out. Always remember to take it one day at a time.
Hey.
how my reaction was to how good. I've never seen a salad bar like that before.
You should go to Texas de Brazil. It's
even I've heard better. About that place too. Now, if it's better than that, I might die after the first bite.
You just die just walking by the building and smelling.